I urge Dilima to proceed with the investigation. And I would like to invite, there's somebody, sir, who told me there was this UN expert that Duterte is not doing enough, to come to the Philippines, have a conference to me in public. You can ask your questions, all that you want to know. But allow me to ask you also. You seem to be characterized as a UN expert, fine. I'm just a simple trial lawyer. So why don't you come here and let's talk about what you are talking about. Extrajudicial killing, I will do the explanation in public for international release if you want. For the things that really happened during the criminals and the police in operations, punitive operations, police action, I am willing to answer all of them. And I said, I assume full responsibility for what happened because I was the one who ordered it. Now, my instructions at the very first day of my term was that go out and hunt for these criminals. Arrest them if they surrender peacefully, but if they put up a violent stand, then you just have to kill him, because I do not want people in government dying needlessly for doing his work. Well, you will then be leaving behind a family and children. Now remember, today we lost another policeman. On the average, on the national scheme, we lose about two, three police officers killed in drug operations. I want the law expert to come here and to count the numbers of deaths also incurred by government with his fingers to guide him how many deaths were caused. For the extrajudicial killing, they say, it's not the work of the police to be wrapping people with plastics and putting it in the bag. That is not the job of the police. I just told him that one bullet will do. Why do you have to wrap it? I said, waste your time. That is not. But we know at the start what we planted, the intrigues there. I am just as I've learned a lot during my prosecution days. We planted evidence. We arrested persons, but we released them. But telling him that it was this person who squealed on him. And then when he goes out but killing, then we said that it was this fellow who really did it, who did you in. We first planted the intrigues so that we would know where they were, from where they came from. It was not until I was the favorite whipping boy of Dilima. She was for the longest time chairman of the Commission on Appointments, Philippines Republic. She was yucking, she never proved anything. When she became Secretary of Justice, she was yucking, accusing me. But she never also initiated any complaint, any accusation anywhere. She just simply loved talking in front of cameras and microphones. Now, she's conducting an investigation against, in the matter of judicial killings. And then she had the goal again to mention my name, Mayor Duterte, that's what I call me. My appellation is really Mayor. That's my nickname, so you call me Mayor. Do not call me President. I'm not used to it. I've been Mayor for 23 years. Just call me Mayor. And I said, Mr. President Duterte, follow me as I start my probe. Good. Then we will have to include all. Your driver, all of the employees, Barlaan, And may I ask you, the name of the house in Pangasinan is named was named under the title was named in favor of under the sister of your driver. Where did she get the money? Tell me. Where did your driver get the money to build such a good house? Can you show me their income? What's their business? And what is the wealth of your driver? He was the only one residing there all the time. And you, Senator De Lima, went there so many times. First during the house blessings, and on weekends you were with your driver. And everybody knows, the Department of Justice employees know about it. When you were the secretary of, or the chairman of the commission appointments, everybody in that agency knew about it, as if you're the only one. You know, the reason why I called for this conference is just to disabuse the minds of the many women criticizing me. I said I have to mention the connect between the Lima's driver and her. Otherwise, I'd look stupid. Why would the inmates obey a driver on the mere approval of a driver? Para kang gago. So, that is one round. Wait until we present these guys. They can maybe deny it initially, but you know, there are a lot of ways of doing it. Allow me to ask you 7 questions, and I would get the truth from your mouth. I am not saying I'm the best, but the 10 years as a prosecutor was a learning process of arriving at truths. UN will come again, and ayoko kasi, because you know, you do not do that because you are interfering in the sovereignty of a country. I am now really very serious. Do not take away by just giving a stupid explanation, because you are infringing into the territory of the sovereignty of the country. What would it be to you if I go to the UN and start lecturing to the employees there? You should do this, you should not do that. And I say, hey guy, this is the UN. This is the United Nations. And so, are you really united? United Nations, when was a United Nation ever really united? They could not control America, they could not control Russia, they could not control the bombings, they could not even plan of how. The problem with this UN is they send UN troops to protect the population. So the war goes out of control. So there's a little fighting, they started, and then the contending parties come in and fight a real war, slaughtering people, and they are not able to stop it. So the United Nations starts a war, but does not know how to end it. That's the problem. Alam nila kung paano mag-umpisa ng gera. Hindi naman nila alam po paano tapusin. You know, when Iraq was being invaded, on the very slim excuse that there were weapons of mass destruction, they were not able to stop the United Nations. Maybe you're guessing, guys. The truth has really come out. There was none at all. So what happened to the country? The United Nations never stopped it. It allowed a war to start. Now they are climbing here and there to stop it. And you come and interfere in my country because there are now criminals killed or even people killed. There is not even a judicial finding that these guys were innocents or these guys were really the gangster. And you just count the bodies there and say that, you know, the United Nations must come in. My God, do you really know what you are doing? Isinali pa siya yung presidente to give a word because you rely on the NGOs. And there is a lady there who keeps on also prodding people. Pilipina yan, nandyan sa United Nations. Nagbibigay ng intriga. At tapos, ito namang newspaper na pick up. How many people were killed by that 600 or 3 million drug addicts? Do you have the count? We have. How many? More than the criminals that are killed today. And who are these victims? Wives, workers, students? And yet you only know how to count correctly when you are counting the carcass of these dead criminals. Cannot even a kind language or sentence of those who have died in the wake of a drug problem as serious as the Philippines. So the next time you issue it, I do not want to insult you. But maybe we'll just have to decide to separate from the United Nations. Eh kung ganun kayo kabastos putang ina, eh umalis na kami dyan sa inyo. So take us out of your organization. You have done nothing anything also. When were you here the last time? Never. Except to criticize. Food world? Where? Where's the food? There's the world, but there is no food. World Hunger Organization, maybe. When have you done a good deed to my country? See, you are contributing money. I said, you're a member. Okay, we go out. And I would invite everybody. I would invite maybe China, the African. They have not been able to stop it. And all of them, the Middle East. Why don't we just form another organization? Why do you have to listen to this stupid... threatening me with what? You want me to go to prison? I said, there are three stakes there. My honor, my life, and the presidency. Do not shit with me. So automatic, agad ang redact.
You're seriously contemplating on separating from the UN, considering that you said...
US, yes, because we have never been a member.
UN, sir, UN.
UN. The joke is on you. You have to refund me with so many contributions that you have made all these years. So, ulan ninyo yung contribution namin. We would go out. We contribute a certain amount to the maintenance of the UN, right? You return the money to us and we'll go out. I can build, with that amount, I can build so many rehab centers all over the country. But there was a time, I think, that a few countries really contemplated of going out. One was China. I do not know what's inside their minds now. But, huwag ninyo akong wana because it's an affront even when you do that. If it is really the Congress or the people of the Philippines would say that I am not doing enough. I would verily accept that to them. But you do not just throw that kind of allegation or statement without coming even here to just relying on the reports of the newspapers. That's what you do. Fucking, that's what you do. Newspapers and these tabloids. And you make criticisms against the... Remember that I'm not a mayor anymore. I represent the country. Kindly do not do it. So I'd like to talk to that said alleged expert of the UN. I demand that he comes here. Or if he wants, we can go somewhere else to a third country. Let him talk to me and let him face me with hard facts. Not newspaper clippings because, nah. Unless it is edible. You do not do that to, just go around insulting people. You know, United Nations, if you can say one bad thing about me, I can give you 10. But I tell you, you are an inutile. Because if you are really true to your mandate, you could have stopped all these wars and killing. 500,000 already killed. But the goal to call by attention, nagpapadala ka dyan sa mga NGO, mga newspaper clippings and critical, all you do is to read editorials. What have you done for the world, Mr. United Nations? At yung tao na yung expert ninyo, let me, you know, if he comes here, you tell him straight. Mayor Duterte would ask only 5 questions to prove that you're stupid. Only 5 questions. He will just ask you to answer 5 questions. And he will prove to the world that you are a very stupid expert. As if I did. You know, you must remember, baka akala nito, I took AB Foreign Service. Check it out with Lyceum. Political science, then I add another one. Because I had an accident, so motors accident, one of the many. So na-late ako ng isang semester. So my extra time, I took foreign service. Consular practice and procedure, geopolitics, world trade, international trade. Baka ninyo kayo magkaputang ina. Uy, mga ulol. Let's have a debate. Hindi nga ninyo ma-enforce yung mga order ninyo dyan. Ninyo matapos-tapos yung patayan. Then you worry about the lives of criminal, what the bones of the criminals piling up. And so, how about the bones of the other guy on the side? Those who were killed innocently. Had we not stopped it, so the count will continue in favor of the criminals. Just imagine, kung hindi, had I not been the president. And the top narco general was the military aide of a presidential candidate. What would have happened to this country? Gentlemen and ladies, it's 3:00 in the morning. And if somebody knows the song, All That I Ask of You, it's 3 in the morning.
Sir, babula lang, sir. Sir.
Please,
sir.
Let me go home.
Sir, hindi kayo magkaroon ng serious repercussions po yung statements na binigay niyo about UN just now, sir.
What is repercussions? I don't give a shit to them. They are the ones interfering. You know what? They should have started it with the protocol. No? You know, they would have said somebody to talk to me. Or at least the rapporteur. You do not go out and just give a shitting statement against a country. What repercussions? You have fallen short of the protocol needed for respect. And you want me to respect you. you must be a shit. Dapat ganun, presidente na ginaganon mo. Huwag mo munang ipadala dyan. Do not criticize immediately. Itong si Yutnat naman, how do you pronounce the word? He should have written me a letter. Addressed to the Foreign Service. Mr. President, can we have your... My performance as a mayor has nothing to do with it. These are recent events. Na ang bastos, hindi ako. They should suffer the repercussions. You have not followed the basic rudiments of courtesy and protocol. Kayo yung bugok, hindi ako. I studied my laws very well. Look at my records, just malasay. Look at the subjects that I... Consular practice and procedure, international law, international trade and everything. Baka akala ninyo gago ako. At least, bagay, hindi kasing gago mo. Tell din natin, you observe protocol because if you do that directly, you are addressing yourself to me. Remember that I do not like to say it because I want to be called mayor still. I am a president of a sovereign country. Sabihin sa inyo, mayroon ba silang representative dito? Tell them straight. Bastos ka. An American? Indian? Chinese? Ano? Filipino? Or what? Oh, America. Tell this American. Show your respect first. Show your respect. Because sabihin ko, let's start to criticize him. Why are you Americans killing the black people there, shooting them down when they are already on the ground? Answer that question. Because even if it's only one or two or three, it's still human rights violation. God damn, you tell that to that American there. Or better still, tell him that I will pay him a visit if there is time. You just tell me where I can find him. So, you know, the mayor is asking where can he see you. Ako pupunta doon.